the beginning, darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God hovered over the waters.
In the beginning,
God created. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And God said, "Let there be light." God saw that the light was good.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
And God said, "Let us create humanity in our image." So God created humanity in the image of God.
And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us.
I am the light of the world, says the Lord.
Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
Glory be to the Creator, and to the Christ, and to the Holy Spirit. Please be seated.
Thank you. It seems as though everywhere we turn, we hear stories of conflict and hostility. We hear of global unrest in faraway places and local disputes that lead to communities torn apart, and we wonder, will there ever be peace on earth? And yet, as we struggle with this question, tonight we gather longing for hope. During this holiday season, we celebrate joy and laughter, family and friends, and the knowledge that peace is real and attainable. Tonight, as we listen to the beauty created by the Moravian College Choir and Moravian College Women's Chorus, may our hearts be calm. May we each set aside the troubles in our lives and in our world, even if just for a moment, and focus ourselves and our voices on allowing peace to begin with us. I invite you to experience peace on earth in this room tonight. Tonight, as we listen to and sing these stories of faith, we are reminded that throughout time, the God of whom we sing was present in the midst of turmoil, that the child whose birth is celebrated throughout the world was born into political and social unrest, and even through the chaos, there is this promise of reconciliation. As we light candles and sing these familiar carols, may we each know in the depths of our beings that light will overcome the darkness yet again. And so on behalf of Central Moravian Church, Moravian College, and Moravian Theological Seminary, I welcome you to this night of peace.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They have rejoiced before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and his name is Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Here ends the reading.
A reading from the Gospel of St. Luke. In those days, a decree went out from the Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." Here ends the reading.
Let us pray. Gracious God, we come to you in the quiet of this moment, grateful for this pause in our busy lives to be still and experience you in our midst. For this blessed time of year that calls us out of our normal routine, we give thanks. For the hope that was given in the form of a baby, for traditions and ancestors that enfold us into communities of faith, we give thanks. For the lives of young people and the soul-stirring beauty of voices blending as one, we give thanks. Calm our hearts, Lord, so that we may be present in this moment. During this season, when the din of shopping, finals, and finances can become so loud that we are unable to hear the true needs of those around us, give us the strength to stop and listen. Help us to see you in each person we encounter, not only our family and friends, but truly see you in others. Strengthen our hearts, Lord, so that we may be your voice and your hands in a world set on end. Through our actions, let others come to know love and kindness. Forgive us when we fall short. Open our eyes and ears to the beauty around us and help us recognize that we can bring light into this world in your saving name. We pray. Amen.
Sultate,
Please stand. This is the message we have heard from God and declare to you. If we claim to have fellowship with God, yet walk in the darkness,
we do not live by the truth.
But if we walk in the light, as God is in the light,
we have fellowship with one another in Christ's name.
Lord, let now your servants depart in peace.
Place, may we be inspired to begin living more peaceful lives. May the light of these candles give us hope to feel that the future is bright. May the music of this night remind us that the world is filled with beauty. Go in peace. Amen.